Well, it's snowing again. Who'd have thought it? Snow at this time of year. It really gets to me when people complain, you know, my God, it's snowing. What do you expect in January? Blazing sunshine, Ray-Bans and Speedos. The only time I've ever seen snow in June was about 30 years ago. And the company I was working for sent me up to Elgin, well to the north of Scotland, near Norway. And I was delivering some security doors for a supermarket up there. Anyway, on my way up, I was passing Aviemore when I saw snow on the hills. And that is the only time I've ever seen snow in June, other than in pictures. I mean, I suppose if I flew off to New Zealand or Tierra del Fuego, I could see the real thing. But why would I want to travel 12,000 miles just to look at some snow? I don't like the bloody stuff in January. But they we're snowed in. Well, it's not quite as bad as that, but I certainly won't be going anywhere in it. And to compound matters, we're also in the middle of another lockdown, which means we're not supposed to leave the house anyway. I've already cancelled a diabetic eye appointment for tomorrow. Well, if I can't go to the Dog and Duck, she can forget about having her eyes tested. I mean, she don't use them for anything anyway, other than sleeping and looking at the television. And the television's a large screen. We're in lockdown. We're snowed in. What are you going to do? You're tied to the house 24/7. Well, I sit here and I moan about the snow. But that's not the only thing I do. I also write. I spend hour on hour on hour sitting at this bloody machine turning out the words to entertain you people while you're locked down at home. And what thanks do I get for it? Well, actually, I get plenty and I'm usually very grateful for them. The next Sanford mystery is fairly well advanced. It's just past 16,000 words. And don't complain that you can't read the words on that photograph. You're not supposed to. You can do like everyone else and wait while the book comes out. Working title is Death of a Shoreline. And I'm not going to tell you what that means. But to be truthful, it's slightly behind schedule. 10 days in, 16,000 words. Normally I aim at 3,000 words a day, even if they are crap. So I'm about 10,000 words adrift. But not to worry, I'll let you know when it's due out. And in the meantime, I'll carry on drinking tea and looking at the snow. What would you give for a life like mine? I know what I'd give for a different one.